गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन दिस क्लास वी विल कवर आर पेंडिंग कंसेप्ट्स ऑफ चैप्टर जीन प्लांट्स द फूड प्रोड्यूसर्स। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, देर इज़ वन टर्म यूज इन दिस चैप्टर, दैट इज ऑटोट्रॉप्स। दिस टर्म इज़ यूज फॉर प्लांट्स। बिफोर गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन दिस टर्म, आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्लेन यू द प्रोसेस ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन एंड इट्स टाइप्स। स्टूडेंट्स, न्यूट्रिशन इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ इनटेक ऑफ फूड टू गेट एनर्जी। अकॉर्डिंग टू द प्रोसेस ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन, एनिमल आर क्लासिफाइड एज कार्निवोर्स मीन्स फ्लैश ईटर्स, herbivores means plant eaters, and omnivores that eat both plant and animals. And plants produce their own food by the process of photosynthesis, so known as producers. Further, according to the process of nutrition, living organisms are divided into two parts, that are autotrophs and heterotrophs. Autotroph is made up of two words, auto means self and trophs means feed. The organisms that make their own food with the help of inorganic substances like water and carbon dioxide are called autotrophs. As green plants come under this category, so plants are autotrophs. Now I think this term autotroph is clear to all of you. And all non-green plants and animals that obtain their food from other plants and animals are called heterotrophs. Now some differences between autotrophs and heterotrophs. Firstly, autotrophs. Autotrophs make their own food by themselves. This includes plant, protists and some bacteria. Heterotrophs, this cannot make their own food and obtain energy from outside sources, means from other plants and animals. It includes animals, fungi and some bacteria. In our surroundings, there are so many plants and animals. They depend on each other for their needs. As you know all that the green plants are the producers of food and animals depend on plants, particularly herbivores depend on plants, and further carnivores depend on herbivores, and the bigger carnivores depends on smaller ones, and further decomposers decompose the dead animals and plants. In this manner, producers, consumers, particularly consumers means herbivores and carnivores, and decomposers make a continuous chain. This chain is known as food chain. Do you know, dear students, this interdependence is so beneficial to maintain the number of animals in nature. Otherwise, any particular type of animals or plants will increase in number. For example, if there are no carnivores, then the number of herbivores will increase, and indirectly it affects the number of plants and create imbalance in nature. It is not there, my students, that only animals depend on plants. There are many ways in which plants also depend on animals for the dispersal of their seeds. Animals like mice, squirrels, etc. help in the seed dispersal. Now further we are going to discuss about the non-green plants, the only topic that is pending of this chapter. Students, there are some non-green plants that perform the process of photosynthesis like crotons. In crotons, leaves are of red color because of the presence of carotenoids and anthocyanins along with chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is the hidden form, but some plants do not perform photosynthesis. These are categorized as saprophytic and parasitic plants. Firstly, saprophytic or saprotrophs. These are the animals that get their nutrients from dead and decaying matter. Mushroom, Indian pipe and some bacteria come under this category. Afterwards, parasites. These plants obtain their nutrition from other plants and animals. Some grow on other plants like mistletoe and dodder, and some depends on other animals or insects like pitcher plant and Venus flytrap, etc. Students, this was all about the type of nutrition and other non-green plants. Thanks for watching my video. I will be back soon with a new topic. Have a good day.